computer concept name.
Okay.
In a hurry. Mm-hmm. What is the inheritance? Inheritance is the one of the concept. Provided by Java. Which is used for extending the parent class of child class. Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the parent class of child class. We can extend the, all the parent class properties to child class. That is the concept inheritance. Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for extending the parent class up to child class. We can extend the all the parent class up to child class. For example, I am taking one class, father class.
Mm-hmm.
Father, he can earn money. He can drive car. I am giving two functions. He can earn money. He can drive car. I am taking one son class. Son. He can drink and smoke.
Okay.
Functions I am giving. And taking another class, grandson. Play and study. Okay. Here, if you want to learn inheritance concept, just only one logic for we are learning this concept. Just you should remember only one thing. A extends B. That means B properties will come to A. Or A can get all B properties. A extends B means B properties will come to A. Or A can get all B properties. Just for this, only for this logic purpose we are learning this concept. Otherwise, no need of this concept. A extends B means B properties will come to A. Just you should remember this logic. Okay, right. Father, how many functions he is having? Two properties. Okay, now son extends father. What will happen?
Son properties goes to father.
No, logic. Father property will come to son.
Okay.
Son can get
To father. Okay.
Four properties. Grandson extends son. What will happen?
Both son and father will comes to grandson.
So
six properties.
Grandson can get six properties. This is the concept of inheritance. So before going to this concept, inheritance concept, just you should know how to maintain different classes. Yesterday we have taken only one class, that is the boy class. Under class we wrote functions and we called from main method. But today class is different. We are taking three different classes. Father class different, son class different, grandson class different, and we will take another class, main class, that is different. So how to manage different classes today concept, first of all. After that we can discuss inheritance concept. Okay. First today concept, how to maintain different classes. So yesterday we have taken only one class made, that is the by class, under class. We wrote functions and we called from main method in the same class. But here is different.
Yes.
So here we should take four different classes and we need to call the functions from one class or main method. So how we can call? Today we will discuss. So just you should remember A extends B means B properties will come to A. Okay?
Okay.
Right. So how to manage different classes. Go to Eclipse. Take the new project every day. No need to take the project, but I am taking Java project.
Okay.
Click on next. Project name is Hyderabad. Oh, already over. Okay. US. Click on finish. No. So go to SRC, take the new class. I'm taking one class, father class. Only class I'm taking, I'm not taking in main method. So this time taking class. I want to declare the functions only. So I don't want to take the main method. Right here I'm writing functions. Public void. Public void. And function body SYSO control space father admin. Right. I'm writing another function public void drive SYSO.
So you put mirror even non static in a school.
Yes, I'm taking non static. Father driving. So I have taken only one class, that is the by class.
Mm-hmm.
I wrote two functions. Now I'm going to SRC, take another class, new class, sun class.
Okay.
Here also only taking class. Here also I'm writing functions. Sun. Drink and smoke. Sun smoke. Okay. Now save. SRC take the other new class.
Grant. Play.
Play and start. GS play. Study. Right. I have taken three classes, different classes. I wrote two functions. Okay. Right. Now go to SRC, take the new class with main method. Class name is inher. I am taking main method also. Click on finish. Now I want to call father class functions. How we can call?
With the class name reference.
What is that?
Class name reference name equals to what new class that? Name.
What is the syntax? Why we need to write? Why we need to write?
Because they are non-static.
Yes, that is a non-static. So if it is non-static function, yes. If you want to call in same class or if you want to call from another class, we need to create the object. We need to create the object. If you want to call in same class or if you want to call from another class, we should create the object. That is the logic. You should tell, sir, we need to create the object. Why we need to create the object? All are non-static. If you want to call non-static function in same class or if you want to call from another class, we should create the object. Okay, right. Father.
Okay.
F equal to new father. See, now new. Observe carefully. This is new is different. Red color.
Okay.
F dot and F dot drive. Next, sun class functions I want to call. Sun is equal to new sun s dot drink s dot smoke. Next I want to call grandson functions. Grandson g equal to
play grandson.
G dot study. So this is the concept how to maintain different classes. Concept is over. How to maintain different classes. So here we have taken four classes and we call from main method. Save the concept. You can call the function from main method only. This is the one logic you should remember. Okay. If it is in single class, if you want call from another class, we can call from main method only.
Okay.
Right, next question. So next concept, inheritance. What is the inheritance? Inheritance is the one of the concept provided by Java, which is used for we can extend all the parent class up to child class. So father, I have two functions. I'm going to son class. Here I am writing son extends father. Son extends father. What will happen? Father can get or son can get?
Father.
Son can get four properties. So, s dot drive. Grandson, next. Go to grandson. Grandson extends. Son.
Son.
So, your grandson get
four properties again.
2 plus 4, 6.
Oh, no, అది రాయడం అవసరం లేదా గ్రాండ్ సన్ ఎక్స్టెండ్స్ బోత్ సన్ అండ్
నో ఓన్లీ ఫాదర్ సన్ హావింగ్ ఆల్రెడీ ఫోర్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ సో
ఆటోమేటికల్లీ ఓకే దెన్ ఇట్ ఎక్స్టెండ్
yes you are we are extending so all properties will come
okay
g dot drive G dot. This is the concept in inheritance. So, son, okay. Father can get two properties, son can get four properties, grandson get six properties. So, just here we learned only one line. A extends B means B properties will come to A. That's the reason we learned this concept.
Okay. What's the purpose of extending?
So
we are already calling father.
So this logic indirectly we will use in Selenium. So only logic extends. If you use extends, what will happen? So A extends B means B properties will come to A. Only for extends. What is the use of extends means? A extends B means B properties will come to A. Just you should remember that logic enough. Okay. Right.
Okay.
Next concept. Overloading concept. What is overload? If at all, a function more than one time in a class. Metal a function more than one time in a class with different arguments. Different arguments like type of args, comma number of args. Free right. Then the concept is overloading concept. If at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments like type of arguments, comma number of arguments, if we write it, then the concept is called overload concept. So same function we are writing number of times. So same function, if you write in same class number of times, automatically it will show error. Automatically it will show error. But same function I am writing with different arguments, like type of arguments I'm changing, number of arguments I'm changing. So this concept is called overloading concept. If at all a function more than one time in a class. So if you write any function more than one time in a class, it will show error. But here I'm changing the type of arguments or number of arguments. So then it will not show any error. So if we write, then the concept is called overloading concept. Okay?
Okay.
Right. Go to your source. This is the new class. Class name is power. So I'm declaring function. Public. Starting. Void. Add function and write. Before going to this concept, first of all you should know what is variable. What do you mean by variable, madam?
Variable, okay.
What do you mean by variable? It is a name given to a one memory location which can hold the value. The value will be changed in future number of times. It is a name. It is a name given to your one memory location. This is the memory location which can hold the value. I am assigning the value. This value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times you can change the value. So that is variable. Variable is nothing but it is a name given to one memory location which can hold a value. The value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times you can change the value. So that is variable. So variable advantages. Variable advantages. One is reusability. Easy to update, easy to maintain. Variable syntax, data type, variable name equal value. Data type int a equal to 10, like data type variable name equal to value, data type variable name equal to value. That is a variable definition. Variable is not, it is a name given to your memory location which will hold the value, that value will be changed in future number. Variable advantages, reusability, easy to update, easy to update. Data type variable name equal to value, a equal to 10. Right. Next concept. Yeah, overloading concept. So here I am writing add function. So here I am taking two arguments. Int a, comma, int b. Two arguments I am taking. So variable definition is into res variable name equal to a plus b. Yes, no control space, res. So I wrote one function with two arguments. So here I am taking another argument. So first and second is example for number of arguments. Double first and third is example type of argument example. Same function I am writing number of times, three times I am writing, but it is not showing an error. Why? Because I am changing the number of arguments at type of argument. That is the reason it will not show any error. That is the reason it will not show any error. That is the reason it will not show any error. This is the concept of overriding concept. Sorry, so, overloading concept.
అంటే ఇక్కడ డబల్ ఏ డబల్ బి రాసినందుకు
ఇది డిఫరెంట్ డేటా టైప్. ఫస్ట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ ఈజ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. ఫస్ట్ ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్ టూ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్, సెకండ్ ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్ త్రీ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్. ఫస్ట్ అండ్ థర్డ్ ఈజ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. ఫస్ట్ ఇంటీజర్ డేటా టైప్, థర్డ్ వన్ ఈజ్ డబల్ డేటా.
అంటే మీరు మల్టిపుల్ టైమ్స్ ఇచ్చినందుకు ఎర్రర్ రావట్లేదు అని అన్నారు కదా. ఇక్కడ ఎగ్జాక్ట్
నో నో, సేమ్ ఫంక్షన్ ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్స్ బట్ విత్ డిఫరెంట్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్. ఫస్ట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ ఈజ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్ డిఫరెంట్ నా. ఫస్ట్ ఫంక్షన్ ఐ రోట్ టూ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్, సెకండ్ ఫంక్షన్ ఐ రోట్ త్రీ ఆర్గ్యుమెంట్స్. సో దట్స్ ద రీజన్ ఫస్ట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ అండ్ ఫస్ట్ అండ్ థర్డ్ ఆల్సో. ఫస్ట్ ఇంటిగ్రేటెడ్ టైప్ ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్, హియర్ డబుల్ డేటా టైప్ ఐ హావ్ టేకెన్.
ఓకే,
add 10 comma 20 and passing the values, add 10 comma 20 comma 30, add 0.2 comma 0.3, save, run. So answer is 36.0.5. This is the concept of overload concept. So if at all a function more than one type in a class with different arguments, like type of arguments or number of arguments, if we write, then that concept is called overloading concept. Overloading concept is over. Right. Sir, I have small doubt, sir. So this doubt you should ask, you need to ask, but we will not ask any doubts. So what your doubt is, sir, each and every time whenever you are writing function, you are writing void, sir. Why you are writing void? That's your question. Sir, whenever you are writing any function, you are writing void. Why you are writing void? That's your question. My explanation.
I have different question as well, but I'll talk later after.
Okay. So why you are writing void? That's your question. My explanation is, so void means I don't want any return value. So whenever I'm writing void, that means I don't want any return value. That's the reason I'm writing void. If you want to return value in the place of void, you should write the data type. Once if you write the data type, it will give the return value. That return value we need to store into a variable and we can print it. So why we are writing void? So I don't want any return value. So in the place of void, if you write the data type, it will give the return value. That return value we need to store into one variable and we can print it. So for example, so here in the place of void, I'm writing data type into data type I am writing. So here I am writing into data type. So if you write into data type, automatically it will give the return value. So return, right, shabash. Here also in the place of void, I am writing into data type. So it will give return value. So data type I am writing. In the place of void, I am writing data type. Next, in the place of void, I am writing here double. So it will give return. That return value, we need to store into one variable. So I am storing a variable into x equal. It will give return value. That return value I am storing here. by equal. So variable declaration. So data type variable name equal to value. Double z equal. Next. SYSO control space x. What is x if you print? We need to store it one variable and we can print it. SYSO control space y.
Okay.
SYSO control space j. Save. Same answer. So, difference is in the place of void we are writing data. So, one more. So, if it is integer, we can't pass any decimal value. If it is double, we can pass integer values. 2, 3. Mm-hmm. So, result should be 5.0.
Okay.
So that is the concept of overloading and void concept. Okay. Now ask me what.
Now next question is ఏంటంటే ఇక్కడ నాన్ స్టాటిక్ కూడా పెట్టుకోవచ్చా?
Yeah, you can write non static also. So if you write non static, we need to create the object.
I need object data.
So here